short and sweet. Without further ado, roll the intro.
I'm a late bloomer, 3 year on the scene. 20 racks don't feel like nothing to me. Came from the streets, it turned me to a beast. Invisible set diamonds hugging my piece. But me for a show, I need 80 at least. I want the smoke, ain't no keeping the peace. Keep me a razor when I'm in the east. Open them up just like a surgery. Everything burning around me on lit.
What's up, guys? Baku back here. And today's What If, we're doing What If Naruto Was a Prodigy. Let's get into it. The day of the Ninetales attack, all of the Leaf Village would go into terror. The great, fearless Ninetales would be attacking. Minato, the fourth Hokage, would come to save the village. At just in perfect time, as his son was just born. Kushina would have her son in her hands, saying, "He's beautiful." And then, out of nowhere, a masked man appeared. "Huh? Who are you?"
"I am Madara Uchiha, your worst nightmare."
And as soon as Obito would say that, or Madara in this case, would say that, he'd attack. But before attack could even land on them, Minato comes. "Don't you dare lay a finger on my family, ever." Minato would start to fight Obito in hand-to-hand combat and try to leave it up to him. Minato would get onto an open field and start to push Obito back. And he'd win. But not really. Obito would say, "Well, we'll see how the plan works out. See you later, Hokage." Obito disappears. Minato says, "One threat gone, but a bigger one is up ahead." Minato would see the Ninetales form of a Biju bomb, shooting at the Hokage Mountain. Minato arrives just in time, teleports it away, and a big explosion happens in the back. And so, Minato would go up to the Ninetales while getting stabbed with Kushina, but also sealing the Ninetales within him, within his son, Naruto. And his last final words, his last breath, would be, "Naruto, do good and save this world, please." And he would fall out while Kushina, looking back at Naruto, coughing out blood. "Naruto, eat good, do good in school, and also have a fair life. See you later." They both would pass out from dying, and Hiruzen would arrive. He'd see Minato and Kushina, dead body, laying there, hopeless. His eyes become sad, but he sees a baby Naruto right there with a seal on his stomach. So Hiruzen knew what to do. We time skip to Naruto. He's only 5. He's walking down the streets of Konoha. He get glares of death. Glares of intent. Make Naruto run. Naruto would go into the woods. He'd say, "Man, I wish I could just be more powerful. Much stronger. I just want to learn, become a ninja, and even the Hokage. That's my goal. Become Hokage and make sure this world is rid of evil." Naruto would have a plan. He has his fate memory as a little child. He was only 2 years old. Hiruzen took him into his office. Naruto would start crying. Hiruzen gave him a bottle of milk. Naruto would start walking around, or crawling. And he'd see this giant scroll, and he would go over to play with it, but he ruse and pulled them back. Go to present day, Naruto remembers the exact spot. He just has to wait until midnight. Naruto would sneak into Hiruzen's office while it was midnight. No one was there, he was gone. He'd pump up through the window and he'd look around and he looked in that same corner and it was there. Naruto would get this scroll and he'd open it, seeing many forbidden jutsu. Reanimation. Shadow clone. Shadow clone. Let's see. Alright, that's all you have to do. That sounds pretty easy. What's this other jutsu? I'll keep that for later. Naruto would start to write down some of the jutsu. He'd go back home late at night. He'd be in the woods. He'd say, alright, shadow clone jutsu. But one faint clone pops up and it disappears right away. This won't be as easy as I thought. Alright. Let's try again. And after Naruto's fifth try, he gets it down. A perfect shadow clone appears. Naruto's amazed at what he's done. Only his fifth try. Naruto's beliefs would go up higher. His journey to Hokage would begin. We time skip to when Naruto's 12. He's in the academy. He's one of the top 5 ranking students. He can perform clones, shadow clones. Heck, he even knows a little bit of taijutsu. He's even better than Sasuke at it. But there's one thing Naruto is not good at, and that is ninjutsu, which Sasuke has the advantage of over him. Iruka walk up in the classroom and say, "Hello there, children. Today's the day you prove yourself as a ninja. Today's the day we give you a test to see if you're really ready or not." Iruka will call people up one at a time to perform a clone. Naruto's last. He performs a perfect clone, but not a shadow clone. Naruto will be seated. He'd look over, seeing Sasuke give him glares. Naruto looks at Sasuke with a smirk face. He thinks to himself, "Well, I guess we'll see, Sasuke, if you're thinking what I'm thinking." The day would go on, and then the fights would come. Everyone would do their fights, and the last fight to be called up, Naruto, Uzumaki, Sasuke, Uchiha, please come up to the stage. They'd come up into this dirt field. Iruka would say, "Perform the hand sign." They'd give the hand sign, turn around, walk back. Iruka would yell, 3, 2, 1, begin. Naruto turns around in a quick burst, catching Sasuke off guard as soon as he turned. Naruto hit Sasuke with a gut punch and then a kick to his stomach, sending Sasuke flying. But Sasuke gets back up and Sasuke says, "Fire style, fireball jutsu," performing the hand signs and blowing a giant fire, a mid-sized fireball. Naruto would look at the fireball. He doesn't know how to cancel it out, but he does know how to dodge it. Naruto dodges out the way, but as soon as he dodges, another one comes his way. And as soon as he dodges, this one, another one. They repeatedly after, until Naruto dodges the last one, Sasuke appears beside him while the fireball is in front of him. Gotcha, Naruto. But Naruto would jump over the fireball, and Sasuke didn't know what to do. And then Naruto would go for a kick into Sasuke's face, but Sasuke would duck. And then Sasuke would grab Naruto's leg, throwing him around. But Naruto would catch his footing, grabbing Sasuke's arm, and throw him on the ground. While Naruto's still in the air. While Naruto's in the air, he does a roll and points his fist out while Sasuke is on the ground and says, "Naruto, ground punch!" And he would lay a devastating blow to Sasuke's stomach, making the ground crack. Sasuke spits up just a little bit of blood and he gets knocked out. Naruto's the winner! Everyone looks in amazement. What? He beat Sasuke? But how? Sasuke's the number one student. Naruto turns around. He's the number one? I may be number five, but that doesn't mean in many aspects he can beat me. He'd look at Shikamaru, giving him a thumbs up with a giant smile. Shikamaru returns with a thumbs up, but a lazy, slouchy thumbs up. Hours would go by since Naruto passed the test. And he'd wonder, I wonder, what was my family like? Who were they? A mother? Father? Did I have any siblings? And why is my last name Uzumaki? He'd have these random thoughts. And then all of a sudden, that's where we'll be leaving off this part. Thank you for waiting, and I'll be back with another video. Peace out.